welcome back to Auto Repair, guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. If you guys have a Dodge Chrysler or Jeep vehicle and you have the codes, guys, okay, let me explain you quick. If you have a code P0201 all the way, okay, to P0206, we're going to explain how to fix any of those six codes. Okay, I'm talking about 201, 202, 203, 204, 205, 206. Pretty annoying, right? So, if you have any of those codes, guys, you have engine light on, the car will feel like it's misfiring and one cylinder is off. So, it doesn't mean that you have all the codes. You can have just one, you can have two. Most likely you just have one of the codes, and we'll explain why and what's causing that. So, we're going to go ahead and start this Dodge now here, guys, and you're going to feel that the car is misfiring. Okay, it's definitely misfiring. Engine light is on. Okay, just shaking, unbalanced engine a little bit. So what we'll do, we'll turn it off. Then we need to make sure that the ignition is on, the car is not running. Okay, and what we'll be using here, guys, Maxicom. This scanner is amazing. You can find it listed in the description of the video below. This is amazing scanner, guys. I'll definitely recommend to, okay, check that thing out. Nothing sponsored here, it's a product we love. So that thing works not just on a Dodge, Jeep or Chrysler. Okay, these are all the different makes, okay, that it supports. So we'll click VIN, auto detect. It's going to decode all the information from the VIN number, and it's going to automatically select the vehicle that we have. So we do not have to worry about manually selecting it and trying to figure out which configuration, which engine, which transmission we have and all that stuff. For some people that could be complicated. We'll click diagnostics, control unit, now powertrain, engine, control module. So we can connect to the engine computer. And we'll click read codes. Check out now what's happening. Okay, the code that we have, P0201, stored fuel injector cylinder number 1. So we have the hood open, guys. This is a 6-cylinder engine, so doesn't matter if you have a 6 or a 4-cylinder. If you have a 4-cylinder, what will happen? You can experience that code up to 204, 204. You will not see 205, 206 because those are for cylinder 5 and 6. So in our case, we have a cylinder, a code 201, which is a cylinder injector number 1. Injector number 1, guys, in most cases, okay, yeah, if you have a V6, it will be on the back side. So you need to figure out which is cylinder number 1 or which is the cylinder in your case. Let's say you have a code 204. This one will mean that you have a bad fuel injector on cylinder number 4. So we have a video how to replace fuel injectors on Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, many vehicles, guys. So check the videos. Probably you'll find a helpful video that will help you fix the problem. Now we have that injector for cylinder number 1. This is for, okay, cylinder number 2. This is part of the fuel rail here. The other ones, you cannot see them. Unfortunately, in order to remove the injectors, guys, you have to do quite a bit of disassembly. So we'll remove, replace ours, and see if that fixes the problem now. So we replaced our fuel injector on cylinder number 1. We have the ignition on. What we'll do next, guys, okay, we're going to go, okay, again, I'm going to go to powertrain, engine computer, and we're going to erase the codes now. Erase codes, we confirm that's what we want to do. Yes, yes. Now, codes have been successfully erased. You can see the light is still on. What you have to do, turn the ignition off. Restart your car now, guys. Okay, I'm going to rev it up a little bit. The car is not misfiring at all. It feels really nice and smooth. And I'll go ahead and read the codes one more time to see if we have anything. No fault codes detected, so that definitely takes care of that problem. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos and see you guys next time.